She's crying. Oh my god.
I still have my shirt.
That's so funny.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I just want you all to know that I feel like I was at the elementary school just now. This hair was saying a bunch of things.
All right. Welcome to the regular meeting of the School Board of Education for the Osceola School District, Monday, February 14th, 2024. I will call the regular meeting to order. Item C is persons who requested an audience with the board. There was none, so we will move on to item C, which is the consent agenda.
So my comment is thank you whoever rewrote the policy.
That was me enough.
Thanks, Amanda.
Yep, sure. Did I rewrite? The wording in the policy.
The wording, yeah.
Yep.
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
Motion by Tysa.
Awesome.
Second by Tori. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed to be nay, that is approved. Item seven, School Board Committee report. First up, we have February 12th, the School Board Workshop.
I got that.
Okay.
All right, so.
It was on the day's call.
I'm not at all, my memory's wrong. Not as bad as mine. Yeah. So, we discussed board development opportunities and that goal, so we reviewed the survey results from what we took and had discussion about where we had some differences per se and talked through all that, so that was good stuff. And then we also talked about strategic planning, and so we did an overview of where we have been in the last, I don't know, like 3 or 4 years and had the data collected. And then COVID came along and struck, and so now we gotta talk about how do we move that forward. And so discuss what the next steps would be, and then getting that one for 2025. School year. So that's it.
Awesome, thank you. On tonight's committee report. I'll take it. Great.
Go for it.
We had admin reports, including looking at our library plan for the district. We got a budget update. We reviewed the second Friday in January count. And then we looked at some compensation review for some school, professional development, and voluntary science. That takes us to item C, is the student representative reports.
All right. I guess I can kick this off. I just jotted a few notes down, starting off, which I forgot about, was Spanish looks a lot different this year. And so one of the ways to kind of really enjoy the moment in those classes is taking field trips. So we went to Fiesta Loca a couple weeks ago, and we were forced to have all conversations with the staff, including ordering and everything, all in Spanish. All in Spanish. While we were there, we watched the middle school office staff try to find their cotton candy machine. So that was really exciting, watching them walk in.
I have so many questions.
You should be giving this to us in Spanish right now.
Yes. I'm not going to do that. Partially because I can't. FPLA had their regional competition last weekend, which went very well. We have a lot of people moving on. It's currently FPLA week, so we had our end of FPLA party on Tuesday, yesterday. Forensics has their first competition this Saturday, which is really exciting. Empty Bowls is really kicking off to a great start. We had a week where a lot of the high schoolers would go to the intermediate school and help with the art projects down there so that we could get those to sell and donate everything with that too. Winter Formal was a couple weekends ago, and that was drastically different this year from last year. Originally, we would host Winter Formal at Schwalhagen because it was a great space to rent out that not a lot of students would recognize, and this year we changed that, so we saved a lot of money by not going there, which we ended up being able to decorate a lot more. We spent a total of, I spent a total of 12 hours decorating, which included like organizing all the decorations and everything. So we put a lot of effort into that, and it was very, very well received. A lot of people really enjoyed the entire night. A lot of people said that it was one of the best decorated and enjoyable nights. We were able to project the Packers game on the screen, which was super exciting, even though we lost, which put a damper on the night, but it was still great to really incorporate everyone into the evening. And why wait there?
Yeah, so a few weeks ago in the gym, we had the Why Wait Fair. Students could come in after they were done eating lunch to kind of go to each of the different tables where one of the projects was and hear what the project is about and what they had accomplished so far at that point. And there were many fun activities, and kids were able to do a lot of stuff to earn fancy prizes as well.
Wellness week was this week, which was a lot of fun because we got...
Who got the picture?
I did take one photo
today.
It was
just so you didn't have one.
Well, I didn't have her, yeah.
I don't think Scott took this one. I still thought.
So this week is Wellness Week. So we had a lot of great dress-up days planned throughout the week. Had a lot of very fun activities. Monday we had all of our staff members write individualized notes to every single student. It's like, as a student, it's very appreciated. Actually, Mr. Wilson wrote mine, and on the front he just put, "You're pretty cool, dash dubs."
I know, I did see that.
And I was like, oh wow, 4 years for 3 words. That was really nice. Flipped it over and there was a whole message on the back. So good laugh about that. So Oscar and Mental Health Matters Club arrived early in the morning to put those on all of the lockers. Yesterday we had a wellness check-in activity during both lunches with a bunch of different activities, which Dr. Silas could probably touch more on because she had a very, very, I can't think of the word, was very active in preparing that. Which was all funded through the money raised through the Light Up the Night Walk that the Mental Health Matters Club did. Today, in the afternoon, like Newton said, we had the Walk, Ride, Rodeo movie, which was really amazing. It was, the entire evening was kept a secret from everyone in the school, which was uncomfortable for me because I've never had a surprise in this school, and it was very interesting not knowing what was about to happen. But it was a lot of fun. It was very, very moving movie. Very inspirational. Great to watch. Tomorrow we have the Just Dance in the gyms during the lunches, which is made possible because we have the new scoreboard. So that's really exciting. And then Friday, Oscar is coming in early along with some Mental Health Matters Club to serve an all school breakfast. Which we have designed for the entire school.
And then this Saturday at 7 p.m., we have Dr. Basketball, which is held by my crew. It's very exciting. We have lots of donkeys.
It was so funny last night after Chad announced it, people looked at me because I know some people from our different race, like, they're like, donkey?
Yeah, it was classic. Needed to pursue it too, so. And then after, whenever basketball gets done, we have a lock-in for the freshmen. It will go into about midnight.
When's the last time we had a lock-in?
Last year.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, we've had a lock-in pretty much every year except for the COVID.
And the drama club just had a lock-in.
Yeah,
I thought one was too, right? The Oscar and School Board Representatives nominations will start at the end of February for next year's representatives, which is super exciting. So,
and then February 29th at 6:30 in the auditorium, the YWA class is holding a TED Talk style presentation to talk about the progress and goals for their projects, and then just accomplishments and how you can help continue to help their projects as the year.
Awesome. I do have a couple things to add to support what they're saying. I think it's really important to note that the school is super responsive to, I would say, what students need. But we talked about liking the photos and having what's written on there. And in the past, it was a big wall of photos in the cafeteria. And it was difficult at some times because students would stand around it. There might be comments that were made. It became hard. And so they adapted. And I really appreciate that Chad and the team adapted. And now they put them on kids' lockers. So if they don't want their picture up, they can slide it in their locker. Some kids grab it off the wall and take it, and then the kids that are left, so they've adapted, and that was really a positive thing to see happen, and I super appreciate that. And to Gavin's point about the Mental Health Matters Wellness Fair, it was just really, really impressive. It's an organization that has 10 different opportunities at tables, and one of them was called Rise Up, and it's a table about preventing sexual assault, and there's you write a little note on a t-shirt and hang it on the line. And to watch, one of the pieces for me that was amazing because, right, this is high school students, and there was a group of young men gathered around the table, and one of them was like, what should I write on the shirt? He's like, I know, consent is key. And I just looked and I was just like, wow, that is powerful. That A, he said it, B, he wrote it, and I'm like, I think that could be the poster for around the school. There was a table for 1,000 Reasons to Live. There were mirrors up that you put positive, what you want people when they look in the mirror to say to themselves, as opposed to what they may be saying to themselves. There was activities, just go over there and play some bags and enjoy yourself. So there was all kinds of, there was some art, there was just all kinds of opportunities. And Claire Patterson did a ton of work to make it happen. And then the students really showed up because it was run by students. They were at the tables engaging the students. And of course, if you went to all the tables, you got entered in the drawing for like top goal for some food. So there were some just real positive moments of conversation that happened when it's students to students. So we're really proud of the students that stepped up to do that. And there was one other piece of that I wanted to do a shout out. So last night you were talking about the basketball game. So you walk in and you see this amazingly beautiful program, senior night, right? Your name's highlighted in here. It's a really cool thing. And so I walked up and I was like, wow, color, we're stepping up. And Peggy Rydeen, who was awesome to see her, greets at the door. And she's like, actually, the Staple donated these for seniors. And I was like, and so you see on the back, it says programs by the Staple, Chieftain alum owned business. Just super positive. And then Pete was actually there and I was sitting on the edge and he's like, how's it going? I'm like, this is pure class. And he's like, it's not that big of a deal. Plus my wife did it. And he's like, but the other thing to know is we're doing this for the girls on Thursday too. Yeah. Those are the feel good moments. That's what makes our place so special. It's the people that, you know, just bring it home because they love what we do here.
How many days
of
school you guys got left?
94.
Oh, not that you're counting.
Includes weekends, but I mean, yeah. Who's counting, really?
Yeah, exactly. You had a countdown rip off?
Yeah, at home.
You need one in the senior hall.
We should.
How many do you guys have left?
Yeah, that was
yeah,
what?
They had a graduation captain and this like big countdown thing and that little glass wall that's like right in the senior hall.
Oh,
gosh. Even our expectations? This is why Connor didn't come to this one. Or any
hospital. All right. Any other questions you guys have?
No.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Great. Item 8 is improving our instructional strategies supporting student learning. A is review and approve new course requests at the high school.
Yep. So we are requesting the astronomy class to be a new course for us next year. So this is a class right now that Mr. Barrett would teach. It's a dual credit class through River Falls. Would be offered to 11th and 12th graders who have already completed 3 credits of science within the science department. One trimester, half a credit, one nodding point. And basically you can read the course descriptions. Anyone, here's your pop quiz for the day. Does anyone know what a quiz are? I'm saying that correctly, not really sure. I don't know what that is.
Thank you.
I know, I was hoping you would correct me, science guy right here.
Like a star.
It is.
The blazing centers of active galaxies. They're gonna learn about it, I'll observe it. So, that's this course, Mr. Barrett's very excited about it. It's another fun opportunity, a different opportunity for kids to get some additional science credits that aren't maybe your typical path.
So then why didn't you answer it faster, Corey?
She didn't pronounce it correctly.
Okay.
You didn't know what she was talking about.
Yeah, so fast.
Taking it back.
Yeah.
Do you ever get like the phonetic sound?
Yeah.
Next time.
So is this gonna replace any class? You're not taking a class already, you're just gonna?
Nope, we've done a lot of course learning the last couple of weeks as we've met with all the departments. And I would say science is the one that we sit there and they say all these things and we're like, sounds good. We don't know what you're talking about. They're very passionate about what they're doing. And it's fun to learn, but it's not replacing anything. It's just we also are creating a rotation with some courses so that families can plan when a course is available. Because when you've got all these options, which are great for kids to have, but that makes numbers distribute more evenly, so then courses don't run and kids are hoping for them to run. So now we put a couple on a rotation that will help kids get into the classes that they want, and they can plan ahead for those classes being offered or not offered.
I think it's a win for our kids and a win for Mr. Barrett.
Mm-hmm.
What what would our minimum number be that run on?
I don't know, we didn't set a minimum number for this.
We did at this time.
Course.
I think typically we try to look at numbers that are, this is like a course would be this year, but seeing what the other classes in this fall. And with it, you know, typically we want to fill 20. Mm-hmm. The way we usually look at things. It'd be the first year, like we said, we're trying the rotation for this next year to help curb that stuff a little bit. So we, as kids plan, that's why we have those parent meetings for high school students, parents right now on our trying as well to try to hopefully communicate these things. But Mr. Barrett is fairly confident that he's going to have some good numbers for this class.
And then how will the dual credit process work? Do they automatically get the credits that are involved, or do they have to test out to get credits that are involved?
At this point,
they actually go on their transcripts. So whatever grade they earn at high school, they can take astronomy without having to pay for the dual credit. They get it at a discounted rate, and then green reduced get even more discounted, or they can take it on college credit. So they can do both. But it is it's transcripted whatever grade they earn. He's actually had some mentor, and he has to teach the same course that they would be taking if they were at UWR.
So some students could be signing up. Dual credit, some students can just be taking them to get high school.
Correct.
Similar to like the teaching class, right?
The teaching class, stats, like AP stats, yeah.
Yes.
So do we have to register them with?
Yeah, there's a whole process. Yeah, there's a whole process with River Falls that we do, and Cold Out actually helps us with it because they have to apply there and do things.
So similar to those early college classes that's coming up.
Yeah. So this would be one, honestly, there's not much you can deny for early college credit, but this would be one that we could, because it's literally a match to what UWRF is, except if the student can't get it in the time slot that it's offered, then they would have to pay for it there. So they have made it so it used to be in other times with ECCP, if we offered anything that was close, we could say, no, you can't take it. Now they would have to, at the high school, pull a course syllabus and say it's an 80% match. People aren't doing that.
But still, families are paying for it.
Correct.
Yeah.
Families pay for this one.
Families
ECCP.
Pay for it.
Yeah. Does ECCP district pays for up to 18, families pay for the dual credit.
Oh, okay.
So it's very similar, but the FTC is very different.
We have lots of opportunities for our students to earn free, paid for, and college credits. At one point, I think it was Chad actually, we did a tally of how many credits they earned in our district. It's amazing what kids can walk away with.
I'll make a motion to approve the course request.
Motion to approve. I'll second it.
second by Jan. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those who say nay, that is approved. Item B, review and approve early college credit program applications.
Those are for summer school, right? For kids to take it like during the summer?
These are summer, yes.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Motion by Krista.
Because that's right, because the next round is due like March 1st.
Motion by Krista, second by Cory. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
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 Those who say nay, that is approved. Item C, review and approve the district library plan.
So we are looking for approval for the plan that was presented today. And what would be submitted would be the website link to DPI.
So the easiest part, that's a new process. Like you literally have to put your link in there and then they want to look at it. In the past, you just had to say, we have a library plan.
So if it has to be submitted to the state?
Oh, we just put in the URL and then apparently they're going to click on it when they have extra time.
And they are clicking on some because the district, what their library plan is, if they want their library to look like Starbucks, that was their whole plan. So they are looking at them.
That one didn't get approved.
No.
There's some other PPI that is.
I'll make the motion to approve the district library plan.
Motion by Cory. Second by Krista. Any further discussion?
Just a huge thank you for the team.
All right. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those who say nay, that is approved. Item 9, aligning and developing our facilities to best meet educational safety and security goals. A is the 2024 building projects referendum.
Well, as we said, we're going to talk through where we at every meeting. So what have we been up to? As you walked in today, you saw the board on the easel. So those have arrived. And we actually have some canvas ones that are the full size that we used to have way back. Those people were around. I think we celebrated 150 years. So it's kind of a long time ago. But we have those coming. They are going to be in the high school auditorium, the gym entrance, the secure entrances, we have the pool entrance and the secure entrance at the middle school, we have my kids club at the intermediate and at the front entrance, trying to have the boards available where we have traffic going through so people can see it quickly. We also have some out in town. Dick's Fresh Market has one, I saw it today. The library, we will have one. And then it was fun, I was at early learning days that Julie talked about, and I had a table that was very nicely decorated. It had plants and everything. And to Julie's point, seeing grads come back excited about being in Osceola was really fun. And yes, it made me feel old, but I still celebrated every one of those students that I recognized or that maybe recognized me. Some funny middle school stories as well. But with that being said, parents coming by that are our newest learners, that was a really positive experience. And so I was standing with staff, so they helped generate some ideas of places to go. They thought we for sure had to have a sign in the bar somewhere, so we're working on it. Went to the PTA meeting last night, just talked to the people there and see what they had for questions and insights. You have in front of you the hot off the press, like literally today, newsletter. So that newsletter will go into everybody, all of our residents of the district's boxes. The hope is to have it land on the week of the 19th, which would be a week before our first meeting, because we have the meetings on the 28th and March 14th. And social media has been posting. Just please know, if you see responses on the comments, April's done a really nice job saying, you know, we don't respond to your, please email directly to the referendum email account. Because the person had a really good question. Your gut is, do you just want to answer the question? But that's not the place to be doing that. So, and We Are Network is running a banner, so if you saw last night. And here's another feel-good moment. So we pay to have a banner along the bottom, and it's just reminding people to vote. And then Mike Fisk, because he's here in Osceola during the timeouts, they can't play music.
So he was just dropping in random things that he knew from our website. So all of a sudden, the What's Brewing for this week showed up, and the Quick Fact card showed up. So that was pretty awesome. So he did nice things just because he could.
No, that's copyrighted.
It's shut down because Chad plays some serious music. Any questions or suggestions of what you're thinking, or anybody that you heard that we should be visiting?
No, I know you guys are doing a lot of work. That is Craig's circling things, so he's really excited. But and I think I know there's a lot of work going into it, the weekly meetings and all that. So thank you.
And up next is there's a postcard that will go up to all of our residents then right before the vote, just for.
Oh, so this, and then another postcard mailing.
Yes. Two, 3 days. It's intended to hit the mailboxes on the 19th. It's at the press, so if you're asking for a change.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you, everybody. Item 10 is aligning, developing, and supporting our staff. Item A is approve summer school compensation.
Any additional thoughts between the last time we talked about where we're at with summer school wages?
Did you have that?
Yes.
I'm excited to hear you. I know, I saw it, but I forgot to follow up. Student workers, kids public. It's like your basic first year study.
So the students start at 1665 students.
You said just a basic kids flip worker, right?
Well, I meant a student, like first year student worker.
$9 for first year student worker, 1965 and then 12. Yep. And that's last year's rates, or is that for this summer? Because we had to get updated rates, didn't we, Julie?
No.
I just wonder if these are low. And I don't know what your demand or need is for student workers, I guess.
It would seem that kids club workers and summer school workers shouldn't be the same thing.
That's
we literally adjusted them.
Yep.
With Sharon. Like every year, and we do the application, we email them and say, hey, what's the student rate for summer? So I don't know if they were last year, so I wonder if they matched what we did.
So this isn't summer, this is just kids club on the salary schedule. So it's not a summer worker.
Oh, okay.
So it's just a kids club worker, not a summer. I'm not sure what the difference would be. But
I am curious. I guess I'm
curious. Why isn't Michelle here today? We could just ask her.
Why did I think of this earlier to ask her, but I didn't.
There are kids club summer workers. We can bring back kids club at the next
meeting.
Could we? That's where, absolutely, for sure.
It says $9.75 for the first year, $10 second year and beyond, $13 after graduation.
For kids club or for summer school?
For summer school.
Yeah, that's what we have on here, but kids club apparently is different.
I would just think that they would be more similar.
Well, I'm just surprised. So like the first year of a student, it's $9. The second year, it's $9.25. So,
I'm
here.
Well, that's an issue too, then.
I know, but it's just a difference of a quarter in that second year. And then it jumps to 12.
It should go up instead of down.
No, it's 9.25, and then 12.25. So there's a big difference between 2 and 3, and not very much.
For regular
kids club.
Evan has a thought. Sorry, that after graduation, it's not like a third year. It's like anyone after graduation. Okay.
That dollar amount is the same for any student worker in any of these categories. So we have kids club student worker, we have an aid student worker, we have a
food service student worker, that dollar amount is the same throughout all of those categories for student workers on the Southeast Central. But it's not the same as, right, this.
Yep, and what about the in the aquatic center, is that the same too?
We don't have student workers listed.
You have lifeguards.
Yeah.
Because they're lifeguards.
They're sure. Yep. We can do some work on that.
To me, yeah. So board, what's your wishes on this agenda item?
I would make a motion to approve the teachers and paraprofessionals in the school as proposed.
Okay.
So there's a motion on the floor, is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Corey, any further discussion?
I'll just go back, so the motion is to move to 30 versus letting it go with the salary schedule. So I actually like the thought of the concept of having it be not playing with the schedule, then you don't have to come back and worry about it anytime, right?
Although it would put us to 29, no, what would it put us to?
It's 29.70, but so is it?
So
it's just a little bit down, but they're coming from 27. And then it continues the wage increase for them going forward.
Do you think it's something we could just move to 30 this year and then look at rolling it out for the next year summer school? I'm sure there's gonna be a few things that this just came out to me. Just a thought. Because we would also then be looking at changing the paraprofessional one as well, right? Keeping it in line with the.
The dollar amount and change?
Right.
The verbiage change.
Correct. So.
Do you need this answer tonight? Can we rework that language and verbiage and have it
come back next month?
For hiring, we aren't until March 14th for our next, but March, maybe March 14th. So to be able to maybe encourage more people to apply would be ideal if we could figure out what the wage is going to be.
But are we putting out feelers now to be hired by March?
Yes, the same values are out right now. They're rattling cages to get people.
So there's a motion and a second as far as business goes.
Is there thoughts concerns when we talk about substantiality or sustainability? If we were to look at the matching it to their chart we have, do you have concerns with that? If we were to do that for the summer school stuff?
If we went with the cost of living increase to summer school pay, is it still sustainable to stay within the summer school budget? That's what she says.
Yeah. The summer school
All those in favor say aye. Opposed would be nay.
Nay.
Okay, motion fails. The floor is back open for additional motions.
That was really working.
Well, you could have amended the motion, but. Okay. So we're back to it. Agenda item is approved summer school compensation.
I would like to make a motion that we tie it to the salary schedule and so it's the hourly wage. So we'd be doing it at the 29.70 and then it's that way every year going forward.
So that's for teachers?
Well, for everyone, because that's how they came up with the paraprofessionals as well. But we're just doing the teacher.
We're doing summer school. The agenda item is
summer school. The summer school.
And the verbiage you just said would be 2970 for everyone, which I don't think is what you meant to say.
Well,
for the teachers.
For the teachers and the paraprofessionals as proposed, because that's the amount that's on the salary schedule, right?
Yep.
So it's tied to the salary schedule.
So point of clarity though, you would want the paraprofessional hourly wage to also be tied to the salary schedule, because it doesn't do that.
Right.
Okay. So the motion, I'm just going to reread it before anybody seconds it, would be to approve the summer school hourly rate to directly be tied to the BA1 lane for teachers, and the starting wage of a 1 to 2 year paraprofessional for paraprofessionals. But an okay summary?
Yeah.
Okay. So there's a motion by Jan. No. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Craig. Now you can talk, any discussion.
Did you say support staff stay?
No.
What did you say that last?
The starting wage to match the year 1 to 2 paraprofessional. So that's the 1665. You moved down.
But what about?
I'm not looking at the right. I
just was thinking in my head that support staff that have more than a year would have a higher rate than that. But
we do. They follow what they're at, what we're saying for the starting. Yeah. Just one
make
starting.
Sure
rate. Yep.
There's a motion by Jan and a second by Craig. Any further discussion?
So saying that, so if they've been here for 3 years, that's what they'll get when they work in summer school too.
Correct.
They won't be at the 1665, they'll be up there. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's and then that will also be directly tied to what the salary schedule entails. So
right. So that they continue to get
that naturally
into
correct.
It as the salary changes.
Correct.
And then we'll come back to student work.
And we'll come back for the student workers next
month. No, in
2 weeks.
Yes. All right. Motion and a second. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed would be nay. That is approved. Item B, approved professional development compensation.
I'll move to have the schedule reflect the BA1 category and follow the schedule that way.
So there's a motion by Craig. Second by Kaisa. Any further discussion?
For teacher danger. I guess
it's a little bit.
All right. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed would be nay. That is approved. Item C, approved voluntary assignment coverage compensation.
So there's no salary good to follow on this one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I think based on the recommendation at one versus what we just approved in the previous two, the issue of 2970. Mm-hmm. And whether I'm here or not. So I'll make a recommendation for the voluntary assignments to be 2970.
Motion by Craig.
Awesome.
Second by Corey. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed would be nay. That is approved. Item 11 is the next meeting information. The first Community Connect session for the upcoming referendum is scheduled for Wednesday, February 28th at 6:30 p.m. in the elementary school cafeteria. The next committee meeting is scheduled for Wednesday, March 13th, 2024 at 5 p.m. in the district office conference. The next regular board meeting is scheduled for Wednesday, March 13th, 2024 at 6:30 p.m. So I stand corrected because I don't have another meeting in February, so I apologize on the student worker one. With that, we're to executive session, so I would entertain a motion to adjourn to executive session pursuant to Wisconsin Statute 1985-1C, considering employment, promotion, compensation, or performance evaluation data of any public employee over which the governmental body has jurisdiction or exercises responsibility, individual contracts, and superintendent annual evaluation. Motion by Kaisa. Second by Corey. Roll call. Craig?
Yeah.
Yeah. Kaisa? Corey?
Yes.
And myself.